In this video, we're gonna look at how I took and edited these ant photos. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. So, spring is coming and it's getting a bit warmer, but still there aren't that many insects outside to photograph. But one kind of insect that I see plenty of right now are ants, and especially forest ants. So I wanted to give you some tips on how to photograph them in a good way. First, let's talk a bit about equipment. Today I was using my Godox TT685 flash wirelessly with a plastic dome that you can find in a hardware store as a diffuser. And I held the flash in one hand and then the camera in the other hand, and that way I get a very flexible lighting setup and a very lightweight camera as well. The lens I was using is the Laowa 25mm, and actually the magnification that goes from 2.5 to 5 times is almost a bit too much. I had to kind of find the photograph very small ants because otherwise I wouldn't fit them in the frame. So what you don't want to do is to photograph the ants while they're crawling on their anthill, because that photo will be very messy, full of distractions and stuff. Better to find a flat surface like a tree nearby the anthill and photograph ants creeping around there. An added benefit with using a tree like this is that I can stand in a very comfortable position and find good angles to photograph the ants without breaking my back. It is good to photograph the ants when it is cold outside. On this morning it was only like 6 degrees Celsius, and that's actually great because the ants move a lot slower then. And actually a couple of days before I tried to photograph ants when it was like 15 degrees outside, and it was almost impossible because they were moving so quickly. So try to go there when it is cold in the morning, or maybe late at night, then they move a lot slower. But even when it is cold and the ants are moving slowly, it is very hard to get them in focus, at least at this magnification. Some out of focus photos can look good, like this one, I like it. But in general, of course, you want to have the eyes in focus, and I actually had to take like around 400 photos in total, and only a few of them I really liked in the end, and those are the ones you're seeing in this video. So you have to be prepared to like take a lot of photos, and this is also why I really value to have lightweight equipment, because then I don't get as tired in my arm from standing around a tree for 1.5 hours constantly shooting the ants. It can be really stressful for your arm and your hand to have a too heavy camera or too heavy lens, so that is something I would really consider. Get yourself a lightweight macro setup. This little video sequence can perhaps show you how hard it can be to focus at this kind of magnification. And this was actually the most cooperative ant that I found during the whole session. This guy was very chill and he mostly just sat there, so he was unusually easy to photograph, but the rest of them were a lot faster. When it comes to settings, this morning I used mostly a shutter speed of 1/60th of a second, and that is pretty slow, but I did it to be able to catch some of the sky in the background in some of the photos, which can look very nice. And it's not a problem to use such a slow shutter speed if you're using a flash, because the flash is very fast and will freeze the action in most cases. I used an ISO of 100 to get the clearest possible photo without any grain, and I used an aperture of f8 and around 2.5 and sometimes 3 times magnification on a full frame camera. I'm gonna show you a great Lightroom tip for how to get good colors in your photos, but first a short message from my sponsor, which is Squarespace. What you're looking at right now is my portfolio website, and I built it completely using Squarespace in less than 30 minutes. I really love Squarespace because it's such an easy tool to use and it's so quick, and it comes with all the functionality that you would expect. You have built-in analytics tools to analyze your traffic and see where they come from. You have lots of beautiful templates. Lots of them are especially good for portfolio websites. And even if they have great templates, you can still adjust every detail on how your site looks. So it's very powerful, yet convenient. Try Squarespace for free, and then when you want to sign up for real, use my code Micael Widell for a 10% discount. Thank you, Squarespace. So let's look at how to bring out the best colors in your forest ant photos. To make them really pop and glow, go into the orange setting here on the color section and change the hue a bit to the left and then increase the saturation a bit. That will make your ant look a lot more vivid and a lot more as it looks in reality when sunlight hits it. So this is just a small tip to make your ant photos look a little extra cool. If you want to see more editing from me, I actually did a live session where I edited all my photos from this photo walk, all like 400 of them. Go look for that and you'll see the whole process from beginning to finish. And guys, thank you for watching. That's it for this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my inspiration newsletter that comes out once a month. It is completely free and it contains inspiration and tips about great photographers. Go to mwroll.com to sign up and get it for free in your inbox once a month. And do subscribe to my YouTube channel. I post new videos every week. That's it for now. Bye.